Hello and welcome again to some more tutorials with myself, GEOSynths. Okay, so I've done a couple of videos with FM sounds, and I've done a live stream with it as well. So if you haven't caught that, then please look on my channel. So I'm going to carry on doing some more FM patches, just essentially using the FM oscillators within the System 8 engine. Of course, it's not strictly just FM, because FM's used for, you know, tonal variations as well. You know, there's no filters as such in a sort of like DX7. But we have the ability to use filters within here, plus all these lovely nice ones that Roland have added as well. So we're definitely going to be using them. So for now, what we're going to be doing, we're going to do like a bass sound, like a kind of garage bass sound. So let's get rid of this shift patch. So we've got a new one, and as usual, you know, the oscillator mix is very low, so I'll put it at about 3/4. So as I mentioned before, with the additional oscillators, there's level 3s and level 4s in the variations. So level 3s, this is how I've just been using them. You know, there's no defined rules, but level 3s, I've been using those for simple sounds or body of sounds to fill out the you know, the bass end, mid-range, that sort of thing. And using level 4s for the kind of attack transients or things that I want to add a lot of harmonics to then carve away with the filters. So, but for a kind of bass sound, especially kind of garage bass, it's very hollow sounding anyway. So we're going to stick with level 3s. So let's listen to oscillator 1. So it's just a sine wave. And of course, let's whack it in mono as well, so we're not playing loads of different notes. I haven't played any much today, so I'll be like I'm wearing mittens or boxing gloves. So let's drop the octave down a little, probably down to 32 feet. Now, the System 8 engine does click a little bit, so I tend to move the attack on to about number 1. Now, the other click that you can hear is the release, so knock that to about number 1. The amp. Now, then just really essentially, you know, bass sound, do you want it to decay? And it'll just die out over the time, or do you want it just to be sustained all the time? So that's what we're going to do for our shape. There's still a little bit of a click. Bring on that release a bit more. You can do it with the filler, but just for now. Let's have a listen to the oscillator types. Now, they all sound like sine waves, essentially. So it's not until we change the colour amount that we will get any sort of tonal change. Not a lot going on in that one, because there's not a lot. You could use that for pads or filling out the body of a sound. An octave added for that one. You could use that one for a bass. There's like, there's like two notes there, two harmonics. Maybe more there. Fundamental. Harmonics. Second one. That's a bit more hollowish to me. Even just doing that. So we'll leave it turned up as well, because we're going to use the filter to bring that down if we need to. Oscillator 2, let's have a listen to that one. I don't think we need anything much more complex than that, but let's have a listen to Oscillator 3, level 3, sorry. We got up to FM 1-2, let's go to 1-3.5, see what tones we're getting with that. It's going a bit too electric piano-y, or organ-y, or bell sound actually. What we could do is actually just go back and use the same one we did in Oscillator 1. Again, let's have a listen. I kind of like that actually. Going over to the bell type one, which is the fourth one. And then, because we're using Oscillator 1, it's got that low ending. I'm going to put, rather than put in Oscillator 2 at the same 32 feet, it's just a mush, let's bring it up just one octave higher than Oscillator 1. Now we could, traditionally with FM, you would utilise, you know, some kind of envelope, so you get that kind of, you know, to create that shape. You wouldn't have a filter, but we do, so we're going to be using them. Now, excuse me while I have my coffee. Ah, Tassimo. Not that I'm sponsored by him, but it's Tassimo Colombian. Oh, it's heaven. And of course, by the end of this video, I'll be paying like... So, we got those two oscillators. Both level 3s. One's oscillator 3 type, the other one's 4 type. At the moment, I've got colour all the way up. And we may use oscillator 3 later on, I don't know. We'll see. So then, let's just bring in... nice bass end for oscillator 1 and bring in oscillator 2. Okay. Now, of course, with FM, things that do give the tonal changes, because when you just listen to some of these FM things, it's like, it's horrible. But really, for it to shine, it needs movement. So it's either going to be assigned an envelope to it, or the LFO to it, or the great thing with the system out engineers that we've got this pitch envelope as well. So even though it's just attack and decay, you can essentially, you know, create a siren type of effect, bring up the attack, so it'll go in pitch, and the decay will go doo. But of course, you can just have the decay and have it going down. But that's when you're going positive. You can go negative with that, and it'll flip that up. but it's great having this separate thing. So what we're going to do, we're going to have... let's have a think. Maybe oscillator 2 assigned to... the pitch envelope. Just have the decay. So if we add it all the way up, you'll hear it'll go rather slowish, but it'll go all the way through it and brighter. As opposed to if we have it just down a bit. I hit the right button by mistake, but may as well. So that's a bit more bass tone-y. So that sounds familiar. Of course, that was the Juno. Right, so what should we have now? What we haven't done is the envelope for the filter. The only reason why I'm thinking that is because I'm thinking of using this envelope to shape that, to shape oscillator one. But of course, it's a bass sound. We want it to be sort of brightish at the beginning, then it sort of slowly goes down like it is at the moment, bright to dark, and then either end or sustain at a very low. So for that, let's turn all that all the way down, cut off all the way down, envelope all the way up, my usual thing. And variation. Let's try, I don't know, bass sound. I'm going to try the Jupiter 8. That's level 3, isn't it? I can try a few different things anyhow. So it's going to be pretty much zero attack. So it's all going to be in the decay, if anything. So of course, we've got sustain all the way up, and the key's held down, but we're not hearing anything. Well, why is that? Well, it's because the sustain's down as well on the filter. No. Garage bass, they tend to sound very, as well as that hollow sound that they have, but they also tend to sound very short and kind of chorusy, which we'll get to later. Now, if that's too short for you, all you need to do, because the sustain's all the way up on your amp, is just bring up the decay. Tweak, bring out some of the harmonics a bit more, bring up the cutoff, bring down the envelope a bit, and what should we do with the key follow? Slightly brighter, just a touch. I know you're probably thinking, oh, what are you doing? But I don't want to edit any of these videos. I want you to see everything. There's nothing worse than when you follow a video on anything. It could be cameras, whatever, and then all of a sudden something's jumped and the knobs or settings have changed. You think, what have they done there? Right. Like, it's not authentic. So it just means you have to sit through this longer. That's okay. No, I won't bother with the pitch. Should we try a resonance? Yeah. That's bringing out the hollowness a bit more. Also knocks out the bottom end a bit, so that's on the Jupiter 8 filter, so we'll try another filter. Juno on a 6. Too much. These are the 4-month things. And a harmonic. That's filter 1. Sideband. That's the system 1 filter. I think I prefer that one. So the bass end's disappeared, so we'll have to bring that back in some way. Either do it with a sub-oscillator, but then we do run the risk of bringing in more harmonics and then creating phasing, which will then cancel out frequencies. Or there's a couple of different other ways we can use. Is that starting to sound a bit too bright? Thank you. let's try then the shape, because it's not much of a shape, is it really, of the envelope, because we've got this pitch envelope, which is just the decay affecting the tone of oscillator 2, modulating the tone, should I say, the colour, modulating this colour. And so let's try filter envelope, oscillator 1. So what we're doing here, the tone, just to explain, we've got at this pitch envelope, and that's changing the tone of oscillator 2. But because I've assigned envelope, the filter envelope, to oscillator 1, this decaying section is changing the tone of oscillator 1. So listen. Not just the filtering, or the length of it, but also the tone. Now, bring up velocity. I don't really put velocity on bass unless it's like a real, you know, trying to be an authentic type bass sound. So velocity to filter, I don't know, a little bit. It will get brighter. So we will have to bring down the cutoff a bit. Okay, I'm kind of liking the sound of that. Now, as I said, this filter has taken away the bass sense. So let's try oscillator 3, because we've got one. I tend to use the triangle more rather than the sine wave. I just think it just sounds a little bit better. So we'll try an octave below. And bring that up. Let's just listen to it on its own. Filter. I'll turn it back off. Bring up the bass oscillator 1 and 2 again. Start with oscillator 1. Gonna one tone. Oscillator 2. Let's bring up 3 to try and fill out that bottom end. There, subtly. Not phasing too much. It's about 3/4. Level's dropped a bit as well, so I'll bring up the level a bit. One thing we can do is use the tone button. If you go right, it makes it brighter. It's like a very rudimentary EQ. Go to left, it'll bring in more bottom end, so we'll try that. And I'll level a bit more. So now it's just minor tweaks, cut off envelope amount, bit of resonance. Got the shape, shape's fine. How the envelopes are affecting the oscillators are fine. The only thing that might need to change is levels of oscillators in the mixer, which sometimes you might leave, but definitely check them out. You can create a lot of different tonal variety from just changing volume levels. That's making it more percussive, bringing up oscillator 2. It's like a bit too much bottom end now. And turn down oscillator 3. Happy with that, so write that. And I guess the next thing is really typical kind of garage or house bass is that they put chorus on the bass sounds. But of course, with chorus, you've got to watch out because it can cancel out the frequencies. One of the great things about the chorus on here is that it has a level of where it will affect the frequencies. So nice chorus. What we got here? No, they haven't brought over that chorus, have they? It'd be great if they brought over the Juno chorus onto that. That'd be great. Anyway, chorus 1, it's pretty cool. Just bring you up the level. Time. Not level down a bit. Turn it off, or just play a note, and then you slowly bring it in. Now, as I say, you know, you've got the abilities, so we go into the menu system, and we go into patch effects, and go over to chorus, which I just missed. Chorus pre-delay, it's stuck at 0, so the chorus straight, I like to have a little bit of separation. So I'm going to push down a note and then move that value so you can hear it. Now I'm on about 18 milliseconds there. There's a little bit of separation of the chorus type of sound and the initial note. Happy with that. Now low cut is down to 25 hertz, so it's applying chorus right down to 25 hertz, which we don't want. So for we want to keep the bass end, we still want chorus on there, so we'll try 200 hertz. Try 250. So anything below 250 hertz now, it's not going to apply any chorus. Now chorus does give the effect of smoothing things out a little bit, so a little bit more tweaks. That percussive element seems to have disappeared a little bit, so I'm going to bring up oscillator 2 again. Thank you. just turn off my mic so you don't hear the clicky, clicky, clicky. And I'll just play the sound so you can hear that. Okay, and that, my friends, right, is how you do an FM bass. Now, I'll do a screenshot of this, and if you're part of my Patreon site, then you will get access to the screenshot and the individual file to download to your System 8. Of course, there's other videos there that aren't freely available on YouTube, so join, and there's other things, discounts on patches and stuff, all of my libraries. So, you know, please join and subscribe and all that kind of thing. Helps me out, and I'll just do more of these then if it's worthwhile doing. Okay, so thank you.